India Beach in 2015, and now she's preparing for Miss World.
I met Priya on Facebook, maybe 2013, I don't remember when, because I was in various groups working disability, and we knew a common person, P.T. Johar, and her father, Dr. Johar, who is running family of disabled. That's how we came to know. And if some of you have seen Satbir Jayate series, when Amir Khan was there, there was a disability episode. For the money from that, earning from that was actually given for our National Family of Disabled, and the video of the gentleman, Dr. Dhar, was also shown there. And so that's how we knew each other, and then slowly we started to talk, and many things happened. I will not say anything more because she's going to trace her life story like I've done, and so let it be, let's hear from her, and I don't want to, you know, kind of preempt her. So this is moving myself, so
let me get this back. Why it is? Okay, I think we can give Priya
mic here. Yeah, you start with the slide and take up the slides.
Thank you for having me here. First of all, I would like to thank you, Nightback and Prabhat sir, for giving me an opportunity to come over here and speak in front of you. Secondly, I would like to introduce myself, who I am and what I am doing presently. As you know, I am the winner of Miss Asia India 2015. And other than that, I am writing for some online websites like the Complete Women magazine. I have worked for Popularium as well, and recently one more book is going to publish called Holding My Tears. I am one of the authors in that. Other than that, I have exhibited my paintings individually and in coordination with the family of disabled, as sir said. Other than that, I have worked for a dress designer too, whose work was exhibited in Dubai and Delhi. At present, I am preparing for Miss Future Award. So now, why I am on Future? Question is, why I am on Future? So initially, I was a normal kid. My life was totally normal up until the age of 19 years. And during first year of my physiotherapy course, I was diagnosed with an autoimmune incurable disease called lupus. Its full form is systemic lupus erythematosus. In short, it is called lupus. So it can damage any of the vital organs like kidney, heart, brain, any. But in my case, that is the rarest case, it has damaged my spine and turning me paraplegic. So within 1 year of my diagnosis, I was totally normal. I used to go to college and attend my classes and all. My doctors did not want me be on steroids because as it is incurable and most of the time patients are put on steroids. I was too young at that time, so a doctor decided that I should not take steroid, and instead of it, he gave me methotrexate. That's a chemotherapy drug. Because of that, I lost my frontal hair and I became bald. And that was the stage where I was hesitant to go to the college and face students and all, and they used to laugh, keep she's looking bald and all. So that was something that was bothering me a lot. Yeah, how would I attend my classes, and this has happened to me and all. So slowly and slowly, I went into depression. And I was diagnosed with schizophrenia, and that was the period I faced that stage for 2 to 3 months. I was on antidepressant, and when I recovered, I got better done. So that hard phase was so hard that I could not came up with it. And later on, I had to discontinue my studies because I was totally bedridden for 18 months. So that period, because I was recovered from depression, So I used to spend my time doing my hobby work like painting, and you could see backside. So I used to spend my time doing paintings, writing, poetry and all. And again, when I was given another immunosuppressive drug that, which is called cyclophosphamide. It is not given to younger people because that is very dangerous drug. But I was bedridden, so doctor said ki if you won't give this medicine to her, then she will die on bed itself. So this is the last option we have. So I was given that drug that, through intravenous. So that was immunosuppressive drug. That is why I got some infections over my skin. My body was filled with pus overall, over my limbs and all. So I went under surgery and all. And during that period also, I tried to start studying. And I took admission in Diploma in Nutrition and Health Education program. But during examination time, I got very much ill. So I had to discontinue that course also. After that, whatever I read now, I used that knowledge in reducing my weight. You may see I was 60 kgs and I reduced it to 45 kgs. So after that, I started teaching my students, school students, doing spent a lot of time doing paintings, crafts and all. So that paintings and crafts, I started exhibiting. I started selling my art and all. And when I left my studies na, at that time, one of the parents came to me and said, why don't you teach my kid more than an hour because he's too weak. I said, see, I'm not working anywhere. So if I'm spending extra hours, then you have to pay me extra for that extra hour. She said, why would I pay you? You are only 12th pass. And that comment hurt me a lot. And then I decided I will finish my studies, I will continue studying and I will achieve my degrees. I am not going to get another statement like this from anyone else. Then I got admitted in BCA and MCA, topped in my regional center in both the courses, BCA and MCA. And finished my MCA, then I went to USA to my sister's house, and when I returned, Prabhasa told me, why don't you go for MWI, Miss Wheelchair India contest. I was really a little reluctant because I had stage phobia, a big stage phobia, because I used to get blackout, I used to forget everything in front of the people, what to say and not. So because of that stage phobia, I was reluctant. Otherwise, I was confident regarding my knowledge and intelligence and all. That was the only thing that I was bothering about. So in 2014, I just skipped it. You know, I don't want to. In 2015, he again told me, why don't you participate? You haven't sent your pictures. At least you send pictures. It's not sure, no, you will be selected, but you send your pictures. Then I sent my pictures.
No, she did a lot of nakra in selecting.
And then they interviewed me on telephone, saw my videos and pictures and all. I was selected in top 7 finalists, and then I went to the contest, faced the audience, introduced myself, and there were 2 rounds. One ethnic round, another was the evening gown round, and there were some rounds that we had to pick one chip and talk about that topic. So I did that too, and then the rest is the history. That's all. Thank you. Two messages that I want to tell you. First thing is what I have experienced through my life. कि जब हमारा माइंड और बॉडी दोनों कहते हैं कि लेट्स लीव इट, वी कैन नॉट डू दैट, एंड दैट इज द सेम, उसके बाद आप एक स्टेप आगे बढ़ा लो, यू विल बी सक्सेसफुल. दैट आई हैव नोटिस्ड. मेरे साथ कई बार ऐसा होता है कि मेरा माइंड और बॉडी कहते हैं ना यार जस्ट लीव इट, यू कैन नॉट डू इट. अदर ऑन अदर डे आई अगेन डिसाइड कि नहीं यार, गिव इट अ वन ट्राई, लास्ट ट्राई, एंड देन आई गेट सक्सेस. दूसरी चीज जो मैं सोचती हूँ मुझे बताना चाहिए कि एवरीवन शुड अडॉप्ट एटलीस्ट 1 पर्सन. दैट पर्सन शुड नॉट बी डिसेबल्ड और समथिंग, anyone. You may adopt a child, you may adopt an old age, you may adopt a disabled person, anyone, whoever you feel is a needy person. You might be having a neighborhood, people who are old age, they are living alone, they are not with their family members, their kids are working somewhere else. They are so lonely, and the main issue at present is stress and depression. 36% of Indians are suffering with depression. And I believe this is happening because somewhere we are alone, we are occupied with all the tensions that are happening in our lives. We are bothering about our families and all. Somewhere still we are alone. We don't get company. So why can't we be support to those people? That's the message that I want to give. Thank you.
One thing she did not tell you is that she is also a motivator, and she has a YouTube channel of her own. I was showing some of the slides in the tea break, and so she tries to motivate others, but she needs motivation, parents and me, to support systems. So, big.
Last time also when I visited here, I was told by the students that I did not tell anything about my parents. So my parents is a big support to me. Without them, I wasn't here. I couldn't be here.